I'm Jamie Stewart, and since it looks like I'm not going anywhere for a while, I figure I'll talk to you a bit about the style of my new movie, Emotion Selfie. I've been describing Emotion Selfie as a DIY reinvention of the silent film, which sounds pretty crazy to a lot of people. So I'm gonna break it all down for you. First up, the DIY part. I created Emotion Selfie entirely as a crew of one. I'm solely responsible for the story, the direction, the photography, the editing, the score, the color, the compositing. I even starred in it. I grew up as an only child, so I often started my own VHS shorts. I even did it a couple of times in 16mm. The digital DIY movement in the 2000s was a pretty great period. Other filmmakers who crawled out of the same muck were Barry Jenkins, Greta Gerwig, and David Lowery. The thing is, there were so many lousy movies being made, shot handheld with cheap cameras, bad lighting, bad audio, bad acting. The whole thing just kind of got a shitty reputation. And my work couldn't have been more different. I wasn't interested in Verite. I wasn't interested in Cassavetes or the French New Wave. I was into Kubrick and Coppola, the Coens, Spielberg, Gordon Willis, all these great visual filmmakers. And I aspired to be doing the no-budget, one-man crew version of what they were doing. During that early digital DIY period, the cameras I used had flip-out screens that turned 180 degrees. Because I could now see myself, I began shooting myself on a regular basis. One of the really cool things about my work is that because I was focused primarily on movies, I was able to practice framing shots on some of the most photogenic people in the world. The more work I did, the better I got. I often contributed to Filmmaker magazine, so I would get sent new cameras or software to review. This gave me the ability to experiment with things like special effects, animation, or slow motion. For the end of 2011, fed up with the generic library tracks I was being forced to use on a lot of jobs, I began composing my own music as well. And at that point, I became a fully functioning one-person crew. And now, the silent film stuff. In 2013, after finally giving up on a more conventional feature I'd been trying to get made for half a dozen years, I decided to fully commit myself to the motion selfie style. And I thought it would be a really inspired idea to make an entire feature in that manner. To make this work, I was going to have to create a unified style. After giving it a lot of thought, it occurred to me that something I really was not going to be able to do well was record my own audio. It was just one thing too much, so I decided to not use dialogue. So the silent film element wasn't the result of some kind of formal experimentation. It was purely a practical decision. In fact, the idea of it being a silent film never even really crossed my mind. My point of reference was something totally different. Music videos. I grew up totally obsessed with the late 80s, early 90s music videos directed by David Fincher, Mark Romanek, and Spike Jonze. Which leads me to Janie's Got a Gun. I'm just gonna straight up say it. David Fincher's video for Janie's Got a Gun is a complete and total filmmaking masterpiece. I cannot explain to you the impact it had on me when I was 14 years old. It completely nuked my skull. I'd never seen anything like it before. Fincher compressed a feature film into 5 minutes, and he did it in a purely visual manner. And Jim Haygood's editing completely altered my understanding of cutting forever. This video should be taught in film schools. One of the highlights of making Emotion Selfie was during post-production. I spent 6 months working at the editing company Spot Welders. And one day I got to meet Robert Duffy, who cut all of Romanek's videos. And I demoed a couple of scenes from my movie for him. And so that's what this whole thing is. It's like the Ramones. They combine the sophisticated pop of Phil Spector and the Beach Boys with the caveman aggression of the Stooges. And in doing so, they not only returned rock to its roots, they reinvented it. For Emotion Selfie, I combine the sophisticated high-end filmmaking of music videos with the crude production of DIY. The result returns movies to their origin, silent film, while creating something entirely new. It's something you've never seen before. Well, I'll never be able to fall asleep now.